First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
Peace. We're back once again with Dr. Eileen Bay's show. And tonight, we're going to be dealing with Frankenfood GMOs and their effects on the human body. Now, and how it affects the human body, the effects and the effects. So let's get into that topic right now. If anyone been to Georgia, there's a certain place in which that is set up like stones, in which that is in Georgia, in which that deals specifically with population control agenda, in which that one of the first of the Ten Commandments is basically maintain humanity under 500,000 in perpetual balance with nature. Now, nature should know how many people can exist upon planet Earth. You know, if nature wants to contend with dealing with population control, then it would do so naturally. It would not have to be done by man. So therefore, we know that man or whoever these men are, you know, and women, you know, conducting this nonsense, which we basically know who they are. We can definitely deal with the fact that, you know, the Rockefellers are definitely the top contender, you know, here within the Western Hemisphere, at the behest of those who was funded by the Rothschilds, in which that the Rothschilds were the banking family for the Vatican. Okay. We know that the Pope can basically abrogate any law, you know, in the United States. And that he actually controls ecclesiastical law. All right? As a matter of fact, when we look at the connection between the Vatican, the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, and so forth and so on, and their particular constituents, you would see that Monsanto, with their Terminator seeds, sits at the helm of trying to destroy organic rights and trying to implement their eugenics program through the Terminator seeds, in which that only are they called Terminator seeds because after one crop, you have to go back to them in order to buy or purchase more seeds. But it also sterilizes you in the process. And there's many reports in which that goes into that information on how it causes organ damage and even early death in humans. So it's all part of their population control agenda. As a matter of fact, there was an article by Sean Porter, September 19th, 2012, in which that it says the Daily Mail Frankenstein Food Watch campaign has long highlighted problems with the lack of rigorous safety assessments for GM crops and food. Although GM corn is widely used in the United States, British consumers have turned their backs on the technology because of concerns about its impact on human health and the environment. Although it is not available in British supermarkets, it is fed to farm animals, including chickens, pigs, and dairy cows. As a matter of fact, said Mustafa Jemgos, professor of cancer biology at Imperial College in London, states that the findings relate to eating GM corn were a surprise. We are what we eat, he said. I work at the molecular level on cancer. There is evidence what we eat affects our genetic makeup and turns genes on and off. So, being that we're dealing with GMOs or genetically modified organisms or genetically altered food, organism means something in which that is living. So therefore, if there's something living within this genetically modified substance, then what is this living organism or living thing doing to the genealogy? You know, what is it doing to the molecular or cellular level? What is it doing? It says that he knows that it affects the genetic makeup and that it turns genes on and off. So what if these particular foods have a stop coding within them in order to stop these particular organisms, stop a particular growth? Because what we have found out is that there are children being born now with three strands of DNA and additional amino acids. We can speculate that this is the reason for the genetically altered food. And before 1994, genetically altered food was just something in which that was talked about from the 70s. 20 years later, it was in the supermarkets. This would account for the fact of the banning of the organic farming and the regulating home gardening. The House of Representatives Bill 875 and S-425. Of course, we know that the government has no business interfering or attempting to control farming methodologies. But this is exactly what they're trying to do, is regulate that. And so this bill was introduced into the House from a congressman, or a congressperson, I should say, a Democrat from out of Connecticut, Rosa L. DeLauro, in which that's talk about H.R. 875, the act may be cited as the Food Safety Moderation Act of 2009. If you want the full version of the PDF of the H.R. 875, you can go to https://www.accessacces.gpo.gov/cgi-bin/. And you can go there and check it out, you know, extensively. Now, what is this? Or what are these particular bills supposed to do, or these particular acts? Well, what it does is that it legally binds state agricultural departments to enforce federal guidelines, effect taking the state's power away to do anything other than being food police for the federal government. It effectively criminalizes organic farming, but doesn't actually use the word organic. it affects growing, anyone growing food, even if they are not selling it but consuming it. It affects anyone growing meat of any kind, including wild game. Legislation is so broad, based on every aspect of growing or producing food, can be made illegal. There are no specifics, which is bizarre concerning how long the legislation is. All right, Section 103 is almost entirely about the administrative aspect of the legislation. It will allow the appointment of officials for the factory farming corporations and lobbyists and classify them as experts and allow them to determine and interpret the legislation. Section 206 defines what has been considered a food production facility and what will be enforced upon all food production facilities. The wording is so broad, based on a backyard gardener can be fined or more. So you grow your food in your own backyard, you can be fined or more. In other words, go to jail for it. Section 207 requires that the State Agricultural Department act as the food police and enforce the federal requirements. That takes away the state's power and is a violation of the 10th Amendment. Now, this would account for the fact that right now there are many states, over 20 some odd states, in which that are pulling away from the union, respectively, in which that they are asking or requiring state sovereignty once again, in which that is based on the Constitution. So you have to make sure, look into your state in order to see what is going on, considering that. Now, when you look at Monsanto, of course, you know, this is the company in which that has been tied to this bill. It would definitely benefit directly because it's everything having to do with food production and is controlled and regulated. Monsanto seeds, you know, the pesticides, the fertilizers would provide an easy solution to standardization and farming practices. The fear that I have heard about this bill is the regulation put in place will require all food producers to be standardized by using only approved, in other words, Monsanto's fertilizers and other products. So they are trying to control the food supply. And that's the reason for the vague language, which that can actually spell doom for the organic farm producer and seller, since they're using non-industrialized standard practices already. You know, so, you know, this is what's going on. And we know that genetically modified foods have been shown to cause harm to humans, animals, and environmental. And despite growing opposition, more and more food continues to be genetically altered. You know, if it was produced, now there's a thing that you have to understand is that you have to find food in which that is certified USDA organic. It's non-GMO. And that's the food that you want to find, in which that can be possibly at your grocery stores, allegedly, you know, Whole Foods. You have to look for the labels, but we'll get into that in a second. But there's actually like 10 worst GMO foods for your GMO food list. Corn is number one. You know, if you watch any food documentary, you know corn is highly modified. As a matter of fact, it's estimated that 90% of the corn grown in the United States is from genetically modified seeds. You know, so if you love corn, or if you love popcorn, or whatever the case may be, you got to make sure that it's Arrowhead Mills organic popcorn, or Eden organic popcorn, or Great Northern organic popcorn, or Amish Country popcorn, you know, of that sort. Soy products, you know, is modified. Approximately 90% of this soy being genetically engineered is basically resistant to Monsanto's herbicide Roundup. You know, sugar, according to Natural News, genetically modified sugar beets was the introduced to the U.S. market in 2009, right around the time of this same bill being passed or being brought forth to Congress. As a matter of fact, Monsanto had even had the USDA in the court-related issues with the planting of sugar beets being ordered to remove seeds from the soil due to illegal approval. Aspartame, in which that you should already know about aspartame anyway, has always been destructive. I mean, it always was cancer-causing product. But check this out, papayas. Now, papayas naturally will have the black seeds in it, which that if mixed with organic natural honey could actually destroy parasites and worms, bacteria and viruses in the body. But being that they are now genetically modified since 1999, and they're being GMO papayas being grown in Hawaii for consumption, though they can't be sold to countries in like the European Union, they are definitely welcome with open arms in the United States and Canada. Then you have canola oil. You know what is called the rapeseed. You know, which is one of the most chemically altered foods in the United States diet. You have cotton. You know, found in cotton oil. Cotton originating from India and China in particular has serious risks. Dairy products. You know, not only do it contain growth hormones, which is about one-fifth of the dairy cows in America are pumped with hormones and steroids. You know, in fact, Monsanto's health hazardous RBGH has been banned in 27 countries, but it's still the most used in the United States when it comes to their cow production. You must drink meat, milk, buy organic milk, as if you want to drink it. I recommend you don't because it's still mucus forming. Even though there's other reports in which that speaks about raw milk. Then you have zucchini or yellow squash, which are closely related. The danger of these foods are definitely well known, and how they affect the blood of a pregnant woman and their baby. And the most frightening risks are those in which that is still unknown. As a matter of fact, the best advice is to stay clear from all of these particular foods together that we just made mention of. Most of the grocery products are not labeled GMOs, as you know, and are not required to do so by the FDA, Food and Drug Administration. Therefore, you have to go organic. If you look for the labels in organic, you have to look for the USDA organic or non-GMO project verified. Products such as Simply Truth, Kashi, you know, some of them. We'll get into more of that in a second here. But you definitely want these particular labels. And they're not the most, you know, they're the most reliable that we have as far as these particular labels. You know, if it's a non-organic, you know, product in the North American list, sugar as an ingredient and not made from pure cane sugar, then it is almost certainly a combination of sugar from both sugar cane and GMO sugar beets. If it's the dairy products, then it may be made from cow injected with GM bovine growth hormones. If it is not labeled organic or non-GMO project verified, look for the labeling no RBGH or RBST or artificial hormones. Or you have to pay attention to these labels. You have to read. I mean, it's bad enough that they have foods in which that is, you know, words in which that you can't spell, you know, if asked about it, you know, or these scientific long words in which that is a derivative or chemically processed or hormone made from something from another human or made from plant or animal substance. And there's alternative to dairy products. You know, some of all of the products are produced by the brand in which they begin ready to talk about is verified by the non-GMO project, such as 365, Almond Dream, Blue Diamond, Coconut Secret, Eden, Galaxy Neutral, Nutritional Foods, Growing Naturals, Simply Soy Yogurt. Of course, you know, I ain't big on the soy products. But, I mean, you got whole soy and West soy. You know, you got Rice Dream, Pacific Natural Foods, Organic Valley, Nancy's, Luna and Larry's Coconut Bliss, Honey Melt, you know, Silk, So Delicious, Dairy Free, you know, there's several of them, you know, so, you know, you got to pick, you know, from out, you know, the best from out the worst, basically, as it goes. I mean, you got the baby food, you know, and infant formula, you know, which they tested the food, Goober, I think it was the baby food. I think I'm pronouncing that correctly, but they tested it several years ago and found that it was contaminated. And of course, you know, it's coming from these particular GMOs. You know, so the derivatives, you know, it was that you definitely have to check out and read about. But for baby food or infant formulas, you want, you know, Earth Best as an alternative, Happy Baby pouches, Little Duck Organic, Old Baby Food, Organic Baby, Plum Organic, Revolutionary Foods. You know, these are just some of the foods which that you definitely want to check out. And then when it comes to beverages, you know, or drinks or juices, you know, you definitely want to make sure that they're non-GMOs also. You know, you have Boathouse, which that actually has on it that is not made from GMOs products. It actually has it labeled there. But you have Choice Organic Teas. You have Blue Diamond, 365, Bragg, Earth Balance, Echo Teas, Field Day, Flex USA, Garden of Life, Good Karma, Harvest Bay, Hemp Oil from Canada, High Country, Kombucha, North Coast, Numi, Organic Tea, One Natural Experience, One World, several different other products, you know, in which that even sans or natural soda, you know, Silk, you know, you can use. You know, once again, So Delicious, Dairy Free, Super Berries, Traditional Municipals, you know, Wisdom of the Ancients. Now, you definitely want to use those products. Now, when it comes to body care, you want to definitely check that out too, because there's most of the ingredients within these products and which have been used on our skin and hair are made from GMO ingredients, which is made largely from soy and corn derivatives. You know, so some of all the products produced by the brands, you know, that are featured by the non-GMO project verified are Dr. Bronner's Magic, you know, Sunfood Superfoods, Natural Way, you know, Desert Essence. You know, these are the products that you definitely want to check out. Definitely Dr. Bronner's soaps, you know. They also state on there that they're not made from GMO products. You know, if you have to eat bread or baked goods, you know, being that most of the foods or bakeries, you know, packaged breads or whatever, or et cetera, contain GMO ingredients, such as corn syrup, soy flour, and we're wondering why we got diabetes at a high amount or high level nowadays, and that's the reason why. Anyone would tell you that it's corn fructose sugar. But, you know, there's natural products in which that you can use. Like we said, 365, Home Free LLC, Immaculate Baking, Martha's All Natural, Mary's Gone Crackers, Tree of Life. Now that Martha Gone Crackers, boy, that's a funny one right there. Enjoy Life Foods, Genius, Country Choice Organic, Annie's, Barber's, Boo Natural, Gluten Free Pantry. And that's what you really want. You want foods in which that are gluten free. Because gluten means glue. It's glue. They've used this pink slime substance in which that holds foods together, such as the chicken sandwiches and the burgers and all this stuff. All this, they found that out at McDonald's. That's what they was using. Supposedly, they stopped using it. Allegedly, but we're pretty sure that they had something else that's just as bad. That's how they do. But we have Plum Organic, Revolutionary Foods, Silver Hill Sprout, Sprouted Bakery, Skinny Dipper, Smart Grain, Sweet Earth Natural Foods, Tasty Brand, The Pure Wraps, The Tree of Life. When it comes to candies, because we know that people got sweet tooth and it's hard for them to control that. We already spoke about aspartame, which is a NutraSweet and Equals and all of that is found in over 6,000 products, including sugar, substitutes in salt and gum, candy, desserts, yogurt, some vitamins and even sugar-free cough drops. You know, soft drinks is number one, as you know. You know, so for those who have the sweet tooth, you definitely want to get foods in which that do not have soy lithium in it, because that soy or that corn syrup within the candies is coming from the GMOs, if it does not say 100% cane sugar. But, of course, the foods you would want to check out is some foods, superfoods, once again, Sunridge Farms, Surf Sweets, Sweet Leaf, Tree of Life, once again, Two Moms in the Raw, Vega, Wholesome Chow, Wholesome Sweetener, Sweeteners, Immaculate Bacon, once again, Enjoy Life Foods, Gingins, Go Organic, Go Naturally, Lundberg Family Farms, Licious Organic, Kerr Organic Superfoods, Let's Do It, 365, Coconut Secret, Crispy Cake, or Crispy Cat, Endangered Species Chocolate, Nugget Coconut, Multiple Organics, Now Foods, New Go, so Righteously Raw. So there's many different, food brands in which that you can get, in which that, you can utilize. When it comes to cereal, of course, you don't want to be eating a lot of grains, but if you do, you definitely want the best or some of the best products, in which that is free of GMOs and or either breakfast bars, whatever the case may be. But, of course, you want Arrowhead Mills, Bakery on Main, Hodgson Mills, Friendly Bacon, Martha's All Natural, Mediterranean Organic, Natural Path, Nature's Path, Short Stacks, Ruth's Foods, Sam Mills, Pearly, Elizabeth, Prana Foods, I like that name, Prana Foods. Country Choice Organic, Earth Best, Eden, Enjoy Life Foods, Farm to Table Foods, et cetera, et cetera. OMG Foods Incorporated. So you definitely want to check that out. Then, of course, condominiums, And we, you know, rarely think about this. The condominiums, the oils, the dressings, and the spreads in particular. You know, if you're going to have to choose some type of oil, of course, you can't cook with pure olive oil because it can become toxic. But if you want to use it on like salads or whatever case is, then it will have to be pure olive oil, coconut oil, sesame seed, sunflower, safflower, almond, grapeseed, or peanut oils. All right. We know that they got it locked down on soybean oil and canola oil and cotton oil or cotton seed oil and corn oil. These are the ones in which they have inundated the products with. You know, and we know what soybean oil does. We've been seeing over the last 20 years how it has caused major obesity because they have changed the oils within the foods. And it's caused major obesity within the people. Because, you know, when oil goes into the body, it becomes fat. You know? And you see the effects on which that is having. But there are brands in which that you can utilize, like 365, once again, Annie's, Atlantic Organic, Bragg, Bubby's, Cheddar's, Chosen Foods, Jeff's Naturals, Koyo, the Lumberg Family Farms, Himalaya Salt, Home Appetite, Green Mountain, Gringo, Global River, Garden of Life, Naked Coconuts, Napa Valley Naturals, Naturally Splendid, Enterprise LTD, Nature Ways, New Organic, Sunflower Superfoods, once again, Spectrum Ingredients, or Spectrum, you know, so there's many in which that can be utilized. So that's what we recommend, is you to check them out. You know, Chosen Foods, you know what I mean, it's a long list. You know, Barney's Butter, Harvard Bay, you know, there's a lot of products that you can use, a lot of alternatives. We need to know these alternatives. You know, of course, Whole Foods Market, Whole Harvest, Ziggy Marley, Cocomon, Ziggy Marley's Hemp Rule. You know, Ziggy Marley, you know, the son of Bob Marley, they're getting in on the products. We need to be doing the same thing. You know, of course, you have the dairy products, alternative to the dairy products. It was that we spoke about, but there's more extended to this list. Yeah, Woodstock, White Mountain Foods, Tree of Life, Stratus Family, Creamery, Nancy's, Revolutionary Food, Seven Star Farms, Earth Balance, Earth Best, Life Way, Cascade Fresh, and of course, if you have livestock, raising poultry, or whatever the case may be. If you're dealing in that area, then it would be best that you feed your animals non-GMOs, especially if you are going to eat your products. You know, so Arrowhead Mills, High Mowing Organic Seed Company, Mighty Mustard, Multiple Organics, Revara, Scratch and Pick, Sunfood, Superfoods, you know, Modesto Milling, you know, and of course that's for those in which that still eat meat, but we have to give them a choice also for they can come into their own understanding of these particular sciences, because the less meat that you have, the less dense your body is. And the less potential of becoming constipated, in which that means that your body becomes backed up with the toxins and poison in which that you're supposed to be eliminating. But of course, we got fruits and vegetables, canned and frozen. You know, very fruit, fresh fruits and vegetables for sales are genetically modified. You know, but such as, you know, seedless watermelons are not genetically modified. Small amounts, but small amounts of zucchini, yellow crookneck squash, and sweet corn may be genetically modified. The only commercialized GM food is papaya from China and Hawaii. About half of the Hawaiian papayas are GMO. All right, so you got the fruits, vegetables. It would be 365 Bear Fruit, Cal Organic Farms, Cape Cod Select, Century Market Organics, Eden, Enjoy Life Farm Foods, Farmer Market, Field Day, Fruit Bliss, Funky Monkey Snacks, Grain Place Foods, Jimmy Way Foods, Imperial Gourmet, Jaden Ross Creation LLC, Little Ducks Organic, Mediterranean Organic, Natural Oil Foods, North Coast 1 Degree Organic Foods, Reese, Peggy's Premium, Statue Bush, Island Foods, Sun Foods, Superfoods, Sun Ridge Farms, Sunset, Sunset Kids, Superberries, Tree of Life, Wild Veggie, and Woodstock. These are just some of the particular fruits and vegetables that you can definitely get, you know. And as well as also we're dealing with the beans and the flour and the grain. Because other than corn, no GMO grains are actually sold on the market. So look for 100% wheat flour. Of course, you know, wheat doesn't do good for O blood types. You know, of course, you have it when you get these particular foods, make sure you get them according to the blood type so-and-so. Just want to make mention of that. But pasta, couscous, rice, oats. Now, rice is one of the foods in which that is genetically modified. A lot of, but you got to be careful. So you got to make sure it's particular rice brands in which I'm getting ready to go over in a few minutes. Oats, barley, dried beans, except for soybeans. All right. So, of course, we have 365, Alton Echo, Arrowhead Mills, Ballin Organic Oil, Benito, the Bean Chip, Chosen Foods, Coconut Secrets, Corn Master, Dealer, Eden, Energy Foods, Fantastic World Foods, Field Day, Freakalicious, Gluten Free Pantry, Grain Place Foods, Green Island Rice, Hemp Oil from Canada, Hodgson Mills, Whole Grain, Jolly Bean, Kamut, Lotus Foods, Lundberg Family Farms, Mighty Rice, Mensa, Mensley, Multiple Organic. And I'm saying these words kind of slow so that, you know, if someone is writing them down, they can, you know, make sure that, you know, they're getting them just in case they want to change their particular eating habits and know what foods in order to get and what products to get, I should say. Plum Organic, President's Choice, Rice Select, Sage V Foods, Simply Origin, SK Foods, Stone Bird Flower Company, Tree of Life, True Roots, Wholesome Child, Woodstock Yoga, Pacific Northwest Farm Corporation, 1 Degree Organic Foods, Natural Express, Naturally Splendid, Enterprise LTD. Of course, when it comes to herbs, spices, and other ingredients,
Although there's no spice that are genetically modified, sometimes spice combined may include soy or corn derivative. Some of all of the products produced by the brands below, and which they begin ready to talk about, are verified by the non-GMO project. And they are the Empress Kitchen, Farmers Market, Field Day, Don Chuck Wagon, Dr. Hernandez, Brand Grain Gain Formulas, 365, Mediterranean Organic, Meijer's Naturals, Miso Master, Whole Grain, Root Foods, Sun Foods, Superfoods, Whole Pantry, Woodstock, Numi Organic Tea, Multiple Organic. All right. You know, as you notice that we, you know, gave some things concerning those who are still eating dairy, you know, who are not complete vegans, but are somewhat vegetarians, but they still have a dairy based diet, or have dairy within their particular diet. Of course, you want to eliminate as much as possible because it does cause mucus, you know, but of course, everything is in moderation. And everything in time, you know. But you want to make sure that if you also are, as we would say, you know, cutting back on the meat, you know, you have to understand the science of meat, the worms, in which that are embedded inside of it, in particular pork, which has the trichinosis worm, and how deadly it is. Now it can go throughout the body, and particularly in the brain, and cause all types of problems with your digestive system, with your with causing high blood pressure, causing diabetes. Even cancer has been known to be caused by a fluke worm, in which that comes through meat. All right, so you want to be definitely careful with that. You want to be able to cleanse yourself out. You want blood cleansers, such as alfalfa, which is a blood builder, yellow dock, red clover, hardiaco, echinacea, golden seal, chickweed, chaparral, garlic, black walnut, wormwood, cloves. You want to be able to have these as blood cleansers, as well as also digestive cleansers to enhance the digestive system. You need fenugreek, marshmallow root, slippery elm, senna, aloe ferox. You know, these are some of the best ones. All right, so you definitely want to keep your system cleansed. If you're doing fasts, you want to make sure that you work yourself up into a fast. You want to be able to eat the meal, then the next day eat light, such as a salad. The next day, maybe drink, you know, vegetable juice, fruit juice, water, and then go completely without any type of substance for about a day to 2 to 3 days. All right, some say longer if you do Queen of Fools plan, Heal Thyself. In her book, she goes into the 21-day fasting cycle. All right. If you want to go into that particular, you know, if you are really, you know, poison and toxins are really in your system like that, you definitely want to do so. But I recommend that during that time period that you drink water. Not just go without liquid, but you definitely want to drink water. You know, because water is going to help cleanse out that system. And the water that you want to drink is alkaline water. Water, at least that is 7.4, which is consistent with your blood and plasma, or slightly higher. All All right. All right. When it comes to frozen meals or packaged food, most of those foods, you know, meals are highly processed. So you got to keep your eye open for derivatives of GMOs such as soy and the corn, the oil from canola, cottonseed, and sugar from GMOs, sugar beets, and et cetera. But alternatives would be Nugget Pizza, Natural Express, Organic Bistro, PJ's Organic, Prana Foods, Red All Natural, Red Moon Organic, Saffron Road, Sambasone, Lubert, Lundberg, Family Farms, Hodgson Mills, Hillary Eat Well, Helen's Kitchen, Fry Group Foods, Field Day, Earth Best, Bowl Organic, A Movable Feast, Smart Grain, Soul Cuisine, Sophie's Kitchen, Sweet Earth Natural Foods, The Pure Wraps, Tree of Life, White Mountain Food. You know, and when you look at the pasta, you definitely want the products in which that is like Ann's or Annie's, I should say, Eden's, Field Day, Hodgson Mills, House Foods, Koyo, Miller's Finest, Mensley, Organic Planet, Pasta Masters, Raisin Moon Organic, Sam's Mill, and True Roots. All right. You know, if you got snack foods, you know, and really there is no GMO popcorn on the market. You know, but we did make mention of the popcorn earlier. Those particular products such as Arrowhead Mills do have a product of popcorn, but you know, make sure you look for snacks that's made from, you know, rice, oats. You know, even though you got to be careful about the rice, because it is said that even the rice might be, you know, genetically modified too, wheat, you know. And of course, the ones in which that use non-GMO oils. So of course, you would want 365 Angie Artisan Treats, Annie's, Arrowhead Mills, Attune Foods, Bakery on Main, Barber's, Bear Fruit, Bean Fills, Benito, the Bean Chip, Bites of Bliss, Borders, Canyon, Natural Foods, Cave Chick. No, that's a funny one too. Century Market, Chris Root, Crispy Cat. No, that's a funny one too. Doc Day in the Kitchen, Earth Best, Eat Pantry, Eat Smart, Eating, Edward and Son, Enjoy Life Foods, Environment, Eviro Kids, Flamis Organic, Feline Organic Foods, Fruit Bliss, Garden of Eden, Glutino, Golden Temple, Goldmark Marco Incorporated, Good Healthy Natural Foods, Gold Picnic, Grain Place Foods, Green Mountain, Gringo, Hail Mary, Hemp Oil Canada, Hi, I'm Skinny, Funky Monkey Snacks, and etc. So you definitely want to check those out, you know. You know, and there's other brands such as Taste of Nature, Tasty Brand, The Better Chip, The Simply Bar, Tiny But Mighty, Tree of Life, Two Moms in the Raw, Vega, Venus, Way Better Snacks, Whole, Alternative, Wood Snack, or Woodstock, excuse me, Plum Organic, Off the Cob, My Chi Delight, Multiple Organics, Journey Bars, Kate's, Kettle Foods, McCur Organic Superfoods, Let's Do It, Let's Do, Licious Organics, Lucy's, Luna and Larry's, Coconut Bliss, Marge's Bakery, Selba, C-Snack, Square Bars, Star Bars, Mediterranean Snack, Mediterranean Organic, Ziggy Marley, Hemp Rules, etc. You know, if you're dealing with the soups and the sauces, and of course you want 365, Amy's Kitchen, Arrowhead Mills, Basic Food Flavor Incorporated. You know, you definitely want those. David Unforgettable, Ian, Emmy's Organic, Koyo, Imagine, San Jay, Tree of Life, Victoria's, Wild Veggie, Woodstock, Momo's, North Coast, etc., etc. Okay. Of course, there's some good vitamins and supplements if you use those. Because now we know that food has become the blemish of nutrients, vitamins, and minerals, in particular of minerals. So you will want to have some type of mineral product every day. All right, you need about 65 to 72 minerals in the body on the every day. And being that the soil, a lot of the soil has been eroded, and if the crops are being grown and then the soil is not being turned for the next crops, then it won't give you the best mineral content. So you will want Barlean, Organic Oil, Chosen Foods, Coral LLC, DDS, Probiotics, UAS, Laboratories, Desert Essence, Doctor's Best, Flora, Immortality Alchemy, I like that, Natural Vitality, Naturally Splendid, Enterprise LTD, New Chapters, Nordic Naturals, Now Foods, NutriGold, Oreo Organics, Rainbow Light, Nutritional System, Green Gem, Growing Naturals, Health Force Nutritional, Garden of Eden, Fungi, Perfecti LLC, Spectrum, Superfoods, Sunfood Superfoods, Traditional Municipals, Tree of Life, Vega, Yummy Bear Organic. Now, for those who don't know what GMO ingredients are, a lot of them are invisible, as we would say. Processed foods often have hidden GMO sources unless they are organic or declared non-GMO. But of course, you have aspartame, in which that comes up under amino sweets, NutraSweets, Equal Spoonful, and you know, Vina Via, and all of that stuff. Baking powder, canola oil, caramel color, citrus acid, you know, cobalamin, which is vitamin B12. Yeah, they got vitamin B12 from GMOs. Condensed milk, confectioner sugar, corn flour, corn mesa, corn meal, corn oil, corn sugar, corn syrup, corn starch, cottonseed oil, dextrin, dextrose, lithium, soy milk, soy flour, invert sugar, inverse syrup, inositol, vegetable oil, vitamin B12, vitamin E, rye powder, Anton gum, monosodium glutamate, high fructose corn syrup, modified scotch, milk powder, teriyaki, marinades, textured vegetable protein, malt syrup, malt extract, maltodextrin, maltose, you know, glutamate, glucose, fructose, food starch, etc. The list goes on. But these are just some of the particular foods in which that has been hidden within the foods in which that you eat, and you definitely got to be careful. You definitely do. So we'll be getting ready to do. Let's go to the phone line. Let's go to 917, area code 917. Peace.
Hello?
Yes, greetings.
Hi, greetings. How are you?
I'm doing well.
My name is Tracy Piper, and I wanted to call and talk about enzymes and cleansing the colon and prepare how I should cleanse after the holiday.
All right. Sounds good. We ready for you.
Yes.
Hold on.
So do you want me to start talking, or you want to ask me some questions, or?
We're going to ask you some questions. I'm getting ready to bring the sister on now. Deborah, you there?
Oh.
Yes, I am.
All right. We ready for you. You ready?
Thank you so much, Dr. Bay. Thank you for welcoming this interview.
Oh, yeah. No problem. Definitely. Be ready.
Thank you.
Welcome, Ms. Tracy Piper of the Piper Center for Internal Wellness, and thank you, Dr. Bay, once again for welcoming this interview, and happy holidays to all the listeners.
Same to you.
Thank you.
Yes, Tracy. Yeah. Yes, Tracy. You are the owner and the founder of the Piper Center for Internal Wellness in New York. What services do you provide?
We provide many services in the holistic field, starting from massage, acupuncture, reflexology, infrared body wraps, herbal body detox wraps, different types of detoxification programs such as candida detox, liver and gallbladder detox, heavy metal detox, and my favorite of all, colonics.
Okay,
you know,
great.
I did
wow.
it for the last, not because it was the rarest, but it's because it's the best for me.
Oh, okay, definitely. You saved the best for last. That's great. Now, you are a certified colon therapist. How did you achieve that title? On what path of education did you have to go on to achieve that title as being a colon therapist?
Well, I started out actually in the Western paradigm of medicine. So I have a bachelor's degree in biology with a minor in physical therapy. And then I moved to New York. This was from the Virgin Islands. And I moved to New York and got a degree in massage therapy. And then a friend of mine died from severe constipation, and that's how I got into colonics. And I moved to Canada to study colon therapy there. I learned a lot from them, but I also wanted to study the American style as well. But Canadians are a lot much more up on alternative medicine, so that's why I went there first. And then when I came back, I decided to get my master's in Oriental medicine, so that's acupuncture and Chinese herbology. So I did start out in the Western paradigm, but ended up on the Eastern. And
okay. So you're definitely seasoned. That's good to know.
Yeah.
Now, I can tell. Wow, what a lengthy list. Now, you are on a righteous path by healing many with digestive disorders. When did your business come into existence? And what is your mission?
My business started in 2002. It was kind of like sporadic because I was basically trying to get it together between the acupuncture and the colonic and the massage and figuring out what would be a good way to bring it to the public. But in 2005, I opened up my center in Soho in New York, and it completely took off immediately. My mission is basically to try to educate as many people as possible on internal wellness, on not just colonics, but like understanding the food that you put in your mouth, that the food that we eat and it's being digested is the basis of everything, is the basis of health. What we put in and what comes out is the basis of health. So we have to pay attention to what we eat. We also have to pay attention to what comes out after we eat, and where we usually don't do that, we always just, you know, like, you know, a perfect example that we're doing this tonight is tomorrow being Thanksgiving, you know, we have a big feast and people can't move around and it's great, but people don't think about, I ate all that food and the next day nothing much came out, so what happened? And that really has a lot to do with disease, and people don't understand that disease is probably what you're putting in your mouth. You know, what we're injecting into our bodies. And it's kind of hard to think, well, besides diabetes, that, you know, multiple sclerosis or lupus has anything to do with what you're eating, but it does.
Wow. So there's a definite correlation between what we eat, what we consume, and our state of health or our state of well-being.
Exactly.
Now, you just touched on a very important topic. Like you said, we're on the eve of a very important holiday. And, of course, it's a very joyful time of the year, and it's very festive, and we're around family and friends, and we're often indulging in unhealthy eating habits. What do you advise in regards to avoiding eating excessive amount of carbs or excessive amount of fattening food? How can we do this?
I know. It's interesting because on Thanksgiving I eat less than I do regularly because all of that fear. But, you know, it's Thanksgiving. You're with your family and you tell people, well, you can't eat this, you can't eat this, it's just going to turn them off. So what I say to my clients and to my friends is just be mindful. You know, you don't have to have mashed potatoes, macaroni and cheese, rice, you know, sweet potato, stuffing, all of that, and, you know, maybe baby back ribs and a turkey. Like, you don't have to have all of that. And then somehow, maybe you might get a little bit of greens in there. So I always start out my meal with a salad. So, like, tomorrow I'm making a kale salad with avocado and red and yellow peppers, and my dressing will be olive oil and lemon juice. So you're starting out with something green, something alive and raw that is filled with many enzymes to start breaking down and digest and get the food ready, the body ready for food that is cooked. Now, food that is cooked are void of enzymes. So I tend to slack off a little bit on Thanksgiving because everybody knows I'm a little fanatic sometimes, but I still do leave room for, 80% good, 20% bad on Thanksgiving. You know, usually want to be like 90% good, 10% bad. Yeah, and also in like, you know, you have maybe like, you know, 20% bad on Thanksgiving. Regularly, maybe 10% bad in your diet. That means like, you know, I'll have my kale salad with maybe, I'm making escovitch fish tomorrow. So I'll have escovitch fish with kale salad. Perfectly fine. I'm making my entire Thanksgiving dinner for my family that's coming. I'm cooking for 8, and I got a gluten-free. My whole entire meal is going to be gluten-free. So because I'm of African descent, and it's not just African descent, it's a lot of people too, but it's very prevalent in African descent, that we are gluten intolerant or have a gluten sensitivity, and that's in a lot of the carbs that we eat. And so that's why we will eat our food and we feel really bloated afterwards and very gaseous and stuff like that, and you get this tired feeling after you eat. So, or you may even feel like, where you feel like, I just look like I just gained 10 pounds the next day, and you're like, I didn't eat that much. And that's the gluten in the body, in the food that we ate. So what gluten does for everyone, even with people who may not have celiac disease, may not be tested for a gluten intolerance. But what gluten does in, for everyone is it is one of the major foods, and this is actually not now a theory, it is actually a fact. A research and study was done by the University of Maryland recently where they have now shown that gluten as in the food causes the tight junctions in the small intestine to open up. And when that happens, undigested food and bacteria and so forth from the intestines now leak into, from the gut into the bloodstream. And then you have pieces of, say tomorrow, pieces of stuffing, pieces of carrots, pieces of your turkey, little small tiny pieces that you didn't chew properly because you were busy talking with Aunt May, you know, and you swallowed something really fast, and those pieces of food goes into your bloodstream and your body goes, whoa, what is that piece of turkey doing there? That's not supposed to be there. Attack it. And so then your body gets inflamed. And then you get tired and tired.
Is that what they called leaky gut system? Leaky gut syndrome?
That's how leaky gut syndrome is started, You know, leaky gut can start from you just not eating, even forget about the gluten. You're not chewing your food properly, you know. We're at a dinner table in America, I noticed, like in the Caribbean where I grew up, it was very different. Here, everybody eats at a dinner table, eats and talk at a dinner table. So that's when you converse and you talk with your family and you make jokes. When I grew up, there was no talking at a dinner table. You sat down, you ate your food, and then after you ate your food, you cleaned up the kitchen and so forth, and then you got your drink, and then you went into the den, and then you sat down, and then you conversed. So it was a completely different thing here, whereas now it's like everybody talks and laughs, so no one's paying attention or being mindful in chewing their food and digesting the food. Eating is like, it's such a sacred thing where we should really pay attention to it. In New York, you know, we're so busy, and I'm guilty of this sometimes too. I'm so busy, I'm like eating and walking. You know, I mean, what is that? We won't even take the time to sit down for 20 minutes and give our bodies the time and blessing to say, you know what, I'm going to give you 20 minutes to just relax and really enjoy this meal that I am putting into your body that is going to bless you. We don't take the time to do that.
Mm, the power of digestion.
Yeah. Oh,
now,
yeah.
You mentioned enzymes.
Mm-hmm.
Enzymes are often, you recently mentioned enzymes. Now, enzymes are often described as the life force, for without it, life cannot exist. Tell us about the importance of enzymes.
Well, it's like you just said, enzymes are something that make life possible, and they are needed for every single reaction, every single chemical reaction in the body. Nothing like minerals, vitamins, hormones, none of those things can work without an enzyme. Enzyme is the catalyst to get those things to move. It's kind of like if you have, like you have a blue collar worker. You know, you have a bunch of, like a perfect example is now that we're having this hurricane, you know, Sandy aftermath. So you have a bunch of blue collar workers there, and they're getting all the raw material, like the proteins and the carbohydrates and the fats, together, and it's supposed to put these things together to build your home. Well, you can have all the raw materials that you want there to build this new home. But if you don't have the workers, your blue-collar workers, which would be the quote-unquote enzymes, you're not going to begin to build anything. So even though you have the raw material, like the, your proteins and your carbs and your fats, without the enzymes to break them down and build and start bringing, you know, building up the muscles and the tissues and the organs, nothing gets started.
Okay, so enzymes are the foundation.
Yeah, it is the foundation, because life basically will not exist and cannot exist without enzymes, because it converts the food we eat into the chemical structures, such as light. These chemical structures can pass through our cell membranes, then via the cell lining, where we talk about the lining of the small intestine, going into the digestive tract, and then into the bloodstream. And the food must be digested in order for all this raw material to pass through to the cell membrane so that we can actually get some benefit from it, you know?
Yes. Now, it is noted that prolonged heat above 118 degrees Fahrenheit destroys the enzymes in our food. Therefore, it causes stress on the pancreas.
Mm-hmm.
So is it best that we convert to eating raw foods or having a raw food diet, per se?
Raw food would be amazing. We're just spoiled. We came from before fire existed. We came from eating raw foods. Our ancestors ate raw meat and greens. That's how they had it. So, you know, they could eat the raw meat because the raw meat had live enzymes in there. The plants have live enzymes in there. You know, then when we discovered fire, we started cooking these, you know, vegetables and meats and losing the enzymes, and so this food became dead. So it's not, it's kind of like your mom giving you, you know, you said, Deborah, you know, at age 18, I'm going to give you $1 million. And you go, oh boy, this is great. And your $1 million is equal to your enzymes. This is what you're born with. You're born with your with these amount of, you know, these enzymes. And what you're supposed to do when your mom gives you this money is, or these enzymes, is to replenish this, to deposit into your enzyme bank account. But you decide, say you decide, you know what, I'm not going to, I have $1 million. I'm going to buy a house, I'm going to buy a car, I'm going to go on vacation here, there, and everywhere. I'm going to invite my friends, and I'm going to party. And then you forget to deposit any money into the account. And, but that $1 million is dwindling off because you're spending. And that's what goes on in our bodies. We have enzymes that we're born with from our mom and dad when we're conceived and we're born with. But our job is to deposit new enzymes into our body by the vitality of the food that we eat, which would be raw food, live food, fermented food, food that have life in it. So when we cook something above 118 degrees, like you said, we kill everything. So that's why dehydrators are good. Having where it's above, nothing above 115, usually about 105, and you can have all the enzymes still intact so that it can go into your body and do the job it's supposed to do by helping to digest your food. Otherwise, your body will take your enzymes that are there, your metabolic enzymes, which are there to repair anything that's kind of getting out of hand, any mutated cells, it's supposed to repair that. But if it's easy digesting your food, it goes, I'll get back to that cell tomorrow. But then it never gets back to that cell because you keep eating cooked foods. So by the time your body gets back to that cell, maybe that cell has mutated so much that now you have cancer because you didn't have any of your enzyme workers doing their job because they were doing someone else's job because you didn't deposit anything into the account. You just kept using and using and using, and that's what's going on with us. We're to talk about old age or we're aging. No, we're using up all our enzymes. That's what's going on. We're not putting anything in. You start eating some raw food, and you'll see someone actually regenerate. You'll see their skin start to glow. You'll see their eyes start to brighten again. There's a little pep in their step, you know, and all these things are because there are live enzymes in there working and starting to rebuild the body.
Okay, so we have to definitely be mindful of enzyme deficiencies. And definitely, if we can, at times, consume raw food and possibly steer away from fast food restaurants.
Oh, definitely. Well, you know, this is the first time in 9 years, and there's a movement, and, you know, and I commend you and Dr. Bates for doing these talks because, you know, for the first time in 9 years, I heard on the news the other day that McDonald's had a decrease in profit. First time in 9 years, McDonald's and Wendy's. That's like, wow, unheard of. They, like, always make a profit. They went down. So that's just being more mindful, you know, so that, you know, we have a lot of work to do, don't get me wrong, but that was a step in, like, okay, you know, the school, now that they're talking about changing this pink slime from the school come January, where they're not going to be soaking the ground meat or ground whatever that is, in ammonia to burn the fat off, but then they leave the ammonia in there, and this is what they're feeding our kids, and they call it pink slime. You know, they finally said that they're going to stop selling this, and this stuff is sold at major stores. You know, I think some of the stores that they mentioned on the TV was Walmart and Costco and Pat Mark, Key Food, a couple of them, you know, that they had mentioned in the news. I remember, well, I was like, wow, I didn't even know that. also made me more mindful of getting that sulfur when I'm, you know, feeding my puppy. You know, like, yes. I need to give him the same, like, grass-fed, you know? And not realize that I'm giving him slime as well, you know?
Yeah. Mm. Now, sugar is said to be the worst substance one can consume. Why is this so? And how does sugar affect one's health?
Okay, so sugar is the most dangerous thing you can have. Sugar creates inflammation. Sugar, when you create inflammation, you create acidity. Sugar also is the building block of food for candida, which is a yeast. And this is, well, we all have so much issues with sugar in, like, diabetes, you know, with candida, which is what the food feeds the sugar feeds the food for the candida. But the inflammation can go through your entire body, causes systemic infection. So you can end up having sugar creating so much acid, and people keep eating it over and over again, and that acid creates an environment where disease grows. See, disease cannot grow in an alkaline body. It only can grow in an acidic body, and especially if you have sugar. That's why when you have cancer, the first thing the doctors are supposed to tell you, if they are mindful, they should tell you, but some of them don't, because I even have some of them that don't tell their patients that I'm treating, that they should stay away from cancer. Now, some of the new functional medicine doctors, they know this, to stay away from sugar, because sugar feeds cancer. So when they're doing a PET scan, they inject you with sugar. And then they look to see where the cancer, where the sugar goes to, because the sugar will go to the cancer cells. And that's how they're able to tell where you have cancer.
Oh, my goodness. I've never heard of that before.
Yeah, that's how
mind-blowing.
You know, because it goes right to the cancer cells. It's like a magnet straight through it. And that's what feeds cancer. So if you want to stop cancer from growing, slow down its growth, you know, or reverse it, you need to get rid of sugar in your life. And that doesn't mean just processed sugar like white sugar or candies or anything like that. That means carbs, because carbs break down into sugar. It also means having, I don't know, like sweet potatoes that people don't think about that turns into sugar. Their ice cream, their even fruits, you know. They'll have, like, I love grapes. They'll say, I love grapes. Yeah, but if you have a cancer situation going on, you can't have that sugar right now. And then there's a way of you having fruit sugar and actually using that as a cancer treatment, but there's a specific way where you can't eat anything else but that. And that's the whole thing that Dr. Robert Morris talked about at the International School of Detoxification. But you can't mix it with anything else, because if you mix that sugar with a protein or a carb, boom, you're now feeding the cancer again. So it's a very tricky way of how to do that. So most people are not that disciplined. So I just want to stay away from the sugar, because the sugar is going to cause the candida. The candida is going to turn into a fungus, which can be seen as athlete's foot. It can be seen as sometimes people get the discoloration of their toenails. That's candida, now gone systemic. Women will tend to get recurrent yeast infections or recurrent urinary tract infections. Someone may have like a thick coat on their tongue. Someone that has like massive amounts of dandruff or a body odor that just doesn't go away with even taking a bath. There's this scent that keeps coming back or stuff like that. So there's different forms that candida shows up in our body, but we don't realize that, hey, it's the sugar that we're eating that's feeding it. So sugar is a big, big issue.
So from my understanding, you're saying that sugar causes ill health because it causes the body to be acidic and it's out of balance.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we definitely need to refrain from excessive sugar, for it definitely can lead to cancer or ill health.
If you notice that you're a little stiff sometimes, and you're like, you know what, I turned 40 and I'm a little stiff, you know, just take a week off of sugar and increase your water, you'll notice a difference. Just simple as that, you know. Or if you're on gluten, take a week off of gluten and notice a difference. Like, whoa.
Well, that I can definitely speak on firsthand, because I did have certain food allergies. I noticed that when I removed gluten from my diet, I was starting to consume non-gluten food products. I definitely felt better. I didn't feel as full. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Because it's just a filler. You know, as you said, that word, you just said you didn't feel it at all, because gluten doesn't do anything for us. What gluten does is it's a gluey substance that's in the wheat, and what it does is it expands, it gives it to hold the for the yeast to rise. But what it does is, like, when you bake bread, you'll see like little holes in the bread, like it looks like little, you know, like little pockets of air.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And what gluten does is it holds the carbon dioxide that is supposed to be released from when your bread is rise, leavening the bread. You know, that yeast creates carbon dioxide, and that carbon dioxide is supposed to be released. But it doesn't get released because the gluten traps it in there. So now you're taking in all this carbon dioxide into your body that's trapped in the bread. We're supposed to release carbon dioxide. That's why we breathe out. That's why we exhale. So why do we want to hold it in our bodies to poison us? But they don't explain it to you like that. So we just, that's a really good sandwich. I remember that. I've been having that since I'm a child. How are you going to tell me that's not good for me now? You know, that's the sad part.
Yeah, that's the brain that's the brainwashing that continues and
breaking that old habit that, you know.
Now, it is said that colonics cleanses the entire body. What happens or takes place when one has a colonic?
When you have a colonic, basically, well, in my office, we do colonics a little differently from where you would see. You come in, you do an intake form, we assess you. I always start with an abdominal massage. Feeling the abdomen, the abdominal area, what's going on. Is it hard? Is it soft? Is it painful to touch? With a slight touch or with a heavy touch. And that tug gives me different information. And then I turn the person on their left side in a fetal position. And we use, at our office, we use a Dottola machine, which is a regulated, temperature-regulated, pressure-regulated device that helps it's used to move the water in and out of the body. And we also only use disposable speculums, which is what goes into the body, disposable hoses and everything. Everything is one-time use. And so you'll lubricate the speculum, and it goes into the rectum about an inch to 2 inches, not more than that. And then as that goes in, there's a backflow valve on that speculum, so clean water will go in into the colon and come back out through the waste tube that's attached to that same speculum. Clean water goes in and waste comes out. And so there's a little way you can hold the water in to allow it to go into the body and kind of like soak your clothes, like how you soak your clothes. It's like soaks your colon to soften up the stool, and then you feel like, oh, I have to kind of go to the bathroom sensation, and then we release it, and then you see all the goodies come out, you know. You see, you hear the gas come out, or you see the gas comes out. I look to see how long does it take for the gas to come out. If the gas is coming out, is it hard for it to come out, or is it coming out very easily? Is the water still clear? Is the water turning brown or not? If the water is not turning brown right away, and it's, you know, we're 10, 15 minutes into the colonic, and the water that's coming out, it's still clear. That tells me you're dehydrated. You're not drinking enough water, and your stool is too dry to come out. I am not even able to penetrate that with water. So that will tell me that I need to talk to you about your hydration or lubricating your colon. If the stool is coming out and it's very dry and pebbly, again, there's dehydration issues. There's lubrication issues. Are you having enough oils in your system? Omega 3, 6, and 9. You know, EPA, DHA. Are you lubricating your body with that? You can have, you know, cod liver oil. You can do flaxseed oil. You can do coconut oil. But all these things will help to lubricate the colon as well. And we also look to see if there's undigested food, which gives us an idea, is the leaky gut going on? Are you completely getting all your nutrients from your diet? If I can look in your colonic and I can see everything you ate, I know you did not get any nutrients. You're exhausted. You're tired. You know, you're malnourished. You may eat a great, you know, organic, healthy meal, but you're not getting anything from it, so you're wasting your money. So then I need to sit down and talk about chewing your food better, proper food combining, digestive enzymes, that maybe you don't have enough digestive enzymes to break down your food, so maybe you need to take exogenous digestive enzymes, adding that to your diet.
So the food is literally just going through the person? So the food was not broken down at all?
It looks like deja vu. Whatever they put in their mouth comes right out the other end. That's undigested food, so they're not getting any nutrients. They're exhausted. And so their body becomes inflamed and setting up a perfect place for candida to grow, because if you have undigested food sitting around your body, and it starts to ferment, kind of think about if you put a bunch of, you have compost in your kitchen, you know, all your old, you know, leftover scraps of food, and you just let it sit there. You don't do anything. You forget to throw out the garbage for a week. You forget to throw the garbage for 2 weeks. What happens to that food? It starts to rot. You start to get the little flies or, you know, stuff growing there, and then your kitchen don't smell that nice anymore. That's fermentation. That's it, basically rotting inside of you. That's what goes on in our bodies when we do not completely digest our food, and when we do not eliminate the waste after our body has taken out and used all the nutrients. If we are eating 3 meals a day and we are only having one bowel movement a day, or maybe one bowel movement every other day, or for some people one every 3 days or even less, what is happening to that food inside? So you go to the bathroom and your bowel movement and your entire bathroom smells, or your entire house smells. That's coming out. That didn't just happen with that stool. That's how your entire body internal terrain smells. That's not healthy. So if you're going to the bathroom and you're smelling something coming out like, this is really foul, and if you can't take your own scent, that tells you something. A bell should go off saying, you know what? I think I need to clean myself out. Maybe I need to, you know, get a colic, or maybe I need to eat more fiber, you know, which helps, which is a broom, a natural broom to start cleaning things up. Maybe I need to increase my water. Maybe I need to watch what I'm eating.
Now, you spoke upon, of course, colonics and the power of elimination and to evacuate. Now, what are some of the other health benefits of having a colonic?
Colonics have many health benefits in the sense of, like, increasing peristalsis, because colonics is basically hydrating, activating, and eliminating. So hydrating means bringing water into the colon, hydrating the colon. Sometimes we're not drinking enough water, and the body will take the water from the colonic and just hold on to it, because it's like, oh my God, I've been thirsty for so long, you're finally giving me water. So it'll hold on to it. It activates, the colonic activates. When I say that, it means it increases peristalsis. It helps the body to go through peristalsis, which is the wave-like movement of the colon to push the stool down through the different parts of the colon, starting from the cecum. So the cecum is the beginning part that is over on your right-hand side, and then it goes up to the coming up. That calls it the ascending colon. Then when we get off of a rib cage on the right-hand side, and we turn left. And that cord is called the hepatic flexure. We go across by the belly button area there. That's called the transverse colon. Then we make another turn down right by the left rib cage. That's called the splenic flexure. Then we continue to go down. That's the descending colon. Then we kind of make a U-turn by the left hip area there. And that's the sigmoid area. And then we make a straightaway straight down toward the pubic area, and that's where the rectum is. And so that has to go through, make this peristaltic movement all the way through that entire area. Now, the colon is as tall as you are. So if you are 5'7", that's how long your colon is. If you're 6'2", that's how long your colon is. So imagine having 5 feet 7 inches full of stuff that's stuck in there that's not moving out.
Mm.
Not good.
Truly destroying the health. Now, what is the principles you said of
good health?
You said hydrate. You said we need to hydrate, activate,
and eliminate. Those are the three things with tonics. So people say, oh, well, it cures this and cures that. We have, as much as we know what it does for the body, there's no, as the doctors would say, no scientific proof that it does. But it's just common sense. You know what? If you clean your house, it's going to look good. It's going to be much cleaner. It's going to not have, you know, rodents running around. It's not going to have, you know, stuff like that going on. It's anything with your body. If you have a clean environment, you're not going to have, you know, disease popping up. You're not going to have acne on your skin or psoriasis or eczema coming out on your skin, because basically those things is you're pooping through your skin because you're not pooping through your colon. Your body is extremely smart. Your body wants to survive on this earth at whatever cost to you. And that means if you are not taking care of it, it will do what it needs to do to survive. So if you're not going to the bathroom because you don't feel like going to the bathroom because your boyfriend's over and you feel embarrassed, or you're at work and you need to hold it in, and after a while it starts showing up on your skin. You see it in your face, or you see it on in the rashes, or you may see it with people with different, like their hair starts falling out or thinning. There's so many different ways of seeing that you're pooping through your skin, or you're not pooping the way you're supposed to do that, which is through the rectum.
Now, post to having a colonic at the Piper Center for Internal Wellness, you provide probiotics. Why is it essential to one's health after a colonic? And what is the kind of probiotics?
When you're doing colonics, basically, and this is something that has always been a controversy, that when you're doing a colonic, you're losing good bacteria as well as bad bacteria. And that is true. You will be losing some good bacteria, but you can't isolate and say, you know, good bacteria stay here, bad bacteria go. You're going to lose both. So, but your body is constantly making probiotics. Again, enzymes coming in, your body's making these probiotics, which helps make your vitamin K's, your B vitamins are all made from probiotics. So what we do at the Piper Center is we make sure that before you leave, we give you a probiotic, and we give you a 50 billion probiotic that is enteric-coated. So enteric-coated means it's a special coating on it that allows it to be protected as it's going on the digestive tract and do not allow the stomach acid to destroy it, which means it will open up where it needs to open up, which is in the intestines. So we give you that, and we also give you a liquid water with drops of minerals in it, because minerals, again, is needed by enzymes, but also minerals help to balance out the pH of the body. It helps to neutralize acids. And the minerals are also the building blocks of vitamins. They go together, vitamins and minerals. Minerals need the vitamins, vitamins need minerals, and enzymes is needed for everything to work. So we always make sure that you have your probiotics and your enzymes before you leave the office.
Definitely, to replace the good bacteria that's needed in the body.
Correct. Mm-hmm. And to create a perfect balance with the pH.
Yes. Now, you mentioned about fiber being also earlier, about fiber being essential for producing good bowel movements. I know this can be found in apples, bananas, and broccoli, but what other sources of fiber do you recommend?
Yeah, there's soluble fiber and then there's insoluble fiber. So what you just mentioned is soluble fiber and some of the insoluble fiber, because like pectin in the apples helps to digest your food, and we use apple fiber and oat fiber. But also another way of having would be grounded flax seeds. Psyllium husk or hulls. And some people, when they take psyllium husk, which is very good for you in fiber and also in oils, but what I notice from a lot of people mentioning this to me, and even for myself, is sometimes the psyllium husk makes people very bloated, so they don't feel comfortable taking it. So a substitute would be flax seeds, but I always tell people to grind them, because when the flax seeds are whole, they're too smooth. And so they just come right out. They don't have any jagged edges to kind of sweep things off, you know? So you're going to definitely take the flax seeds. Another thing would be chia seeds, which is high in omega-3s. Like tomorrow for Thanksgiving dessert, I'm making a chia seed pudding. And so I'm making, I have my almonds being soaked right now, which is to help get rid of the enzyme inhibitors and activate the enzymes in the almonds. So I'm soaking my almonds right now as we speak, and that will bring the enzymes out and also the calcium and so forth. And then when I make my almond milk, after I finish making it, I pour in the chia seeds in it, and I just stir it in, and then I just cover it and put it in the fridge. And what happens is the chia seeds become gelatinous, so it's kind of like a gel like, and then you just eat that, and then that's amazing fiber for you and a lot of omega-3s, which is great for cognitive function, for your brain, for your colon, for your joints, you know. So you get the fiber plus you get the oils as well, and that's a very simple thing that anybody can do. You just take some coconut milk or cashew milk or almond milk, and you just throw a couple of tablespoons of chia in it, depending on how much you want to make, and make sure it gets mixed up very well in the milk. And then notice I didn't say whole milk or cow's milk or skim milk. I use all nut milk. And then I just cover that in the fridge. And if you don't have time for a fridge, you know, you soak them for 2 to 3 hours, and you can have a wonderful dessert in 2 to 3 hours. I put a nice glass container, and I take about 2 or 3 goji berries or raspberries and goji berries, and I top it on the top of that, and it's the most wonderful dessert.
That's, and you get your fiber. Delicious and nourishing for the body.
Yes. It tastes good, and it looks good.
I just want to remind everyone that I'm speaking to Tracy Piper of the Piper Center for Internal Wellness. Her Internal Wellness Center is located in New York City at 73 Spring Street, Suite 305, New York, New York. And the contact number is 1212-925-0203. That's Ms. Tracy Piper of the Piper Center for Internal Wellness. She is the founder and the owner. And definitely I want to say to everyone, take advantage of the Piper Center for Internal Wellness. She definitely, as you can tell, has a wealth of knowledge and help. And definitely happy holidays to all that are listening, and to Dr. Bay, and, of course, to Ms. Tracy Piper and the Piper family, as well as my family, the Wellington family. And thank you again, Dr. Bay, for once again allowing this interview to take place tonight. And happy holidays to all. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you for having me, Dr. Bay and Ms. Wellington. I really appreciate it. And, you know, people can go on our website and get some information, more information if they'd like, thepipercenter.com. And we're also having some holiday specials for people to get more serious about their health during the holidays or after the holidays. So check that out and mention the radio show, and it will give you a $20 off of any service.
Also,
that sounds really good.
Also, we have some questions in the chat room. One of the questions was, are you on Facebook?
Yes, I am. I'm on Facebook.
And how can I get in contact?
Put in Tracy Piper and the Piper Center, and it'll pop up.
All right. Also, we had a question. They wanted someone wanted to know about a vegan diet, and do vegans actually live longer than meat eaters?
Okay, that is a really good question. I'm going to try to make it as short as possible. Okay, it depends on what type of vegan you are. I have many friends that are vegans, and the most vegans that I know and I have worked on, many of them know what they're doing, but another half of them are what we call junk food vegans, meaning they don't eat meat, but all they eat is junk food. They'll eat falafel, hummus, potato chips. That they don't eat anything else. They don't eat anything green. They don't. So they're a lot of soy. Soy has lots of estrogen in it, which can cause estrogen dominant breast cancer in women, and also increase testosterone, testicular cancer in men. So a lot of, and also soy has a lot of creates a lot of mucus in the body. Mucus is good to a point because it helps to reduce inflammation, but too much mucus can create more problem than anything, because that mucus can now get hardened by the heat in our body and turn that mucus into cysts, and that can stay in your body for too long and turn into like fibroids or something else, or a tumor or something. So be very wary of when you're doing a vegan diet to not go crazy with soy. Understand that the truth about soy, and that the most 85% of the soy being grown now is all genetically engineered.
That's right.
So if you're going to be a vegan diet, which you can do really well and really nourish yourself, you know, having you have your greens and have nuts and seeds, but soak your nuts and seeds. You know, understanding that you need to pull the enzyme out of your nuts and seeds, make a cashew base or a walnut pate out of, or walnut burger out of that's vegan, and you have that with a salad. You know, and you put it in a dehydrator. A dehydrator can cost you $189, and you can do so much amount of food in there. You can do your kale chips, you know, banana chips, and burgers. But have more nutrition than having that soy in there, and the tofurkey and the tofu. Forget about it. Keep it close to the bubble.
Excellent. Thank you, Sister Tracy. And definitely, we're going to check you out on Facebook, because that was one of the questions. And now that you gave it up, I think you'll be getting a whole lot more business and definitely more contacts.
Thank you so much. Happy holidays to you guys. And don't forget to chew your food, okay? Get those enzymes out of it. And have something in your diet tomorrow that's raw to put the enzymes in it to help break down what you're eating. Thank you so much, guys.
All right. Thank you.
Have a good night.
Have a good night.
Good night.
All right, we're getting ready to go to the radio lines, and we got a question from 747-747. You're on the line.
Peace.
Yeah, what's happening? I had a question about, I joined in a little too late. I don't know if you talked about peanuts, because I read in Nation of Islam literature that peanuts is really not, we shouldn't be eating peanuts.
Yeah, well, you know, actually in the Eat to Live Volume 1 and 2, they speak about nuts, period. That eating any type of nut can cause problems because of the fact of the oil. It can clog the arteries and so forth and so on. You know, but most of the time, if a person eats nuts, they only probably eat about a handful or so. But they're talking about massive amounts of nuts on a daily basis. Most people do not eat nuts on a daily basis. So, you know, of course, you can replace that with, you know, particular seeds, you know, as well as also there's certain other things that you can do, you know, as far as, you know, away from, quote unquote, the nuts, you know, there's some good products out there in which that you can definitely get from, like we was talking about earlier, 365 products, as well as also Whole Foods products, you know. So, I mean, there's things that you can do. You know how it reacts on the physical body. Only you know how it reacts on the physical body, so you definitely got to see how these foods react on you. You know, of course, if you eat something and then immediately, you know, you have gas, and of course, you ate a wrong combination of foods, or either you or either that food did not concur properly with you. So, you know, of course, you need to eliminate that out your diet if that does happen, and eat the foods in which that does not cause gas or cause combination issues or problems. So, I mean, there's a lot of things that you can do.
Where it's born, yeah. All right. Thank
okay. You're going to go to area code 314. Area code 314, you're on the line. Peace.
Was listening to you earlier when you were talking about different genetic altered foods.
Yes.
And that gave a lot of credence to the phrase that silent weapons for quiet wars. You know?
Exactly.
Yes, sir. I was having a conversation with one brother. He was talking about he eats soy products, and I was trying to tell him that soy products is not good for you,
right.
Especially for right. Asiatic Moors.
That's
you know?
Right. Like the sister said, for women, what happened is that soy interferes with the estrogen and start producing proestrogen, or prostate, in which that causes that can cause fibroid tumors and cancer within the body. For the males in particular, it can cause testicular cancer, as well as also prostate cancer, because soy beans have a high amount of estrogen, and within us it interferes with and disrupts the testosterone, which is the hormone that we need, you know, to be a man.
Right.
You know? So it interferes with that, and the testes start to shrink, the penis start to shrink. So soy products are not good for males in particular, black males, definitely, you know. So, and we also seen what soy products has done over the last, 15, 20 years or so. All of a sudden, white women have shapes, and you know, black women are becoming, you know, largely obese. So we know that this is all part of the plan of, you know, a quote unquote, population control agenda.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and when we talk about that, we have to look at the fact that these particular foods are interrupting, actually causing pineal gland calcification. It is also causing organ malfunction, you know, and is messing with the sexual reproductive organs, you know. So, you know, we have to look at the way in which that these GMO foods are actually being done, you know, or being, you know, geared towards, you know, damaging the human body. And it's all part of the Rockefeller's plan slash Rothschild slash Vatican, you know, plan, you know, part of the eugenics, you know, population control agenda.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it also diminished a lot of the Asiatic males to be impotent.
Right.
I could aid a lot of population control.
Right.
And
exactly.
Reduce the births among Asiatic Moors. And among our women as well, you know.
Right.
And I've noticed a lot of European women have, like you just said a minute ago, a lot of European women have got shapes that I haven't seen when I was growing up.
Exactly. I didn't see when I was growing up. So
you know,
we know where it's coming from. It's coming from the soybean because of the high amount of estrogen in which that is within it. In other words, they didn't have enough estrogen within their body. It was not manufacturing enough estrogen. So hence, that's the reason why they did not have the shapes in which that they had. But when they started adding the soybean oil to nearly every product on the in the grocery store on the market, then of course, as the people began to start eating this particular food, soybean products, and when you're talking about oil, you're talking about fat. So of course, where is the fat distribution at within the within the female body? Is that the breasts, the hips, the buttocks, and the thighs?
Mm-hmm. Exactly, especially among young teenage women. You know, you see them developing that, probably about 13, 14. I don't know if I'm exaggerating or not, but
no, it's even earlier than that, brother. We got reports of 8 or 9 years old now.
Man, wow,
mm-hmm.
Wow,
yeah,
wow, man. That's unprecedented, you know, in earlier times to see something like that.
Yeah.
So you know something's definitely wrong, seriously wrong. I noticed I've been keeping up a lot of my breathing exercises, as you suggested, because you was telling me at one time that was the other stuff is just as important as your colonics and detoxification baths. And things like that, but what you were stressing that breathing out the a lot of intoxicants out of your system is more number one is the breathing exercise.
Because 70% of the waste produced within the body must come by way of the breathing. And so what happens is that being that we are shallow breathers, the waste stays within the body, so it has to come out in other ways. Through the skin, as well as also through the urination or the defecation, in which that, you know, 20% supposed to come through the skin and 10% through the urination and the defecation, while 70% supposed to come through your breath.
Wow.
So if so if we're not, you know, doing that to those particular levels, then there's going to be problems.
I used to think that was 70% through bowel movement and
right.
urination.
I know. That's what everybody thought, but that's not true.
I used to think that.
No. And so that's how we know that we've been lied to, because everything was that we thought is backwards.
Right. Right.
That was done purposely so that we wouldn't know the particular exercises in which that is used by the Tibetan monks, the Buddhist monks, the Shaolin monks, you know, the Taoist monks, and et cetera, the yogi practitioners, in which that teach the science of breath. We're not being taught the science of breath here within this country, and that's done purposely. Even if you go to particular yogi classes, you get taught Hatha yoga or Bhaka yoga or whatever the case may be, they do not add the breath techniques into the particular movements. And this is a shame, because they are trying to commercialize yoga, and that's what people are getting right now, is the commercialized version of it instead of the pranayama.
So the Rockefeller and the Rothschild Institute also infiltrated the yoga institutions as well.
They infiltrated different nine different branches, which is called the Nine Battlefront of White Supremacy, written by Dr. Neely Fuller and his student, Dr. Frances Quest Welsing, in which she mentioned within the ISIS papers that, you know, you're talking about politics, labor, sex, law, entertainment, health, you know, all of these particular facets are controlled, or institutions are controlled by these particular families, in which that the Rockefellers is probably the richest family in the United States. You know, that's the reason why they control everything. They control Monsanto, in which that has the Terminator seed, in which we talked about that bill, in which that was passed within Congress earlier.
Right.
You know, in which that they was attempting to stop organic growing foods and farms.
Hmm.
You know,
yeah.
Because they want to control every facet of our being.
Yeah, that's true. Because even in the clothes you wear, new clothing you buy, the certain dyes in your clothing. It's fantastic. That's why everybody should wash their clothes thoroughly when they buy them, especially your underwear. Come off the clothes into your skin.
Right.
And they got all kind of ways of killing you, you know. And I was thinking, if they spent all this time and effort in trying to cure diseases, man, what a wonderful world it'll be to live in.
Yeah. But let me explain the reason why they're doing it, because there is something in which that is happening on the planet. Remember, we said that this organically, even though this organic food, you know, is something in which that we're supposed to be eating, this GMO food was something in which that was spoken about in the 70s, mid-70s or so, during the Jimmy Carter administration, or right before it, during the Ford administration. And less than 20 years later, by 1994, it began to go, you know, worldwide, you know, on the market, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, and there's countries in which that started to say, no, we will not accept these particular foods. You know, so what is it in which that they was expecting to happen before 2000? You know, if they started back in 94 with it. Obviously, what the indigenous people were saying about us moving from the third and fourth world into the fifth world is something in which that obviously was true.
Exactly.
And us, you know, becoming, you know, immortal. And them stopping and them trying to stop that by putting these particular foods with these organisms, you know, as stop codons in order to stop our growth, you know, of our genetic structure with the added amino acids in which that's supposed to be growing within us right now. And how there's some children being born right now with three strands of DNA, in which that we're supposed to have 12 strands of DNA or more.
Huh.
You know, so this is something in which that we know that they knew was coming, and I think it was geared towards the indigo children, the rainbow children, and the crystal children, in order to stop, you know, the Christ consciousness from reappearing on the planet once again.
Yes. You said in other countries, the U.S. is almost the number one country that accepts a lot of this nonsense.
Yeah, well, they the ones in which
due to lack of education.
Right, right. They're the ones in which they issue it out. You know, like you said, 90% of the corn products, you know, which are genetically modified, come from out the United States into other countries.
You know, and the other countries are more educated on what's going on than the people here.
Right.
You know, and they are the most, the phrase goes, never underestimate the intelligence of the American people. But as one person, I think it was Anthony Hillard, European, he said that they are dumb.
Right.
Dangerously dumb.
Mm-hmm.
You know. I mean, wow, you know, you think that they, all the technology they have in this country, they will know more, but they don't.
Right. I mean, with the internet and everything, you would think that we would definitely know more, but we don't. So, you know, what is going on? You know, this still is a exertive effort in order to keep the masses deaf, dumb, and blind.
Right.
That's why, I mean, otherwise, we wouldn't have a job, would we?
Right. Just keep them dumb. Don't keep dumbing them down.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
Yep. But we appreciate you, Brother L, coming in.
Yes, sir.
Definitely
drop
on the information. We're getting ready to get on off of here.
First World Order Radio. Finally, we are on the air. No doubt.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance.
Order.
System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics.
Radio.
Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.